Right, so we're here at the Asia Boxing Summit in Taipei. It's the second day. We just came out of the Rubini-Hayes debate. An active debate. People got grilled there. So my name is Yuri van Gielen. I'm the founder and CEO of Billbox Group. And I'm here together with Thorsten, who is working for Komodo. And just before we started, I understood that Komodo is not as much a privacy coin as I thought it was. Can you share a little bit more about what Komodo is currently building?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. So you're not the only one associating Komodo with privacy.
Yeah.
And that's not wrong. Like, Komodo did indeed start as a privacy coin back in 2016. So Komodo is originally a fork of Zcash. And we had privacy features, and they were quite prominent.
Yeah.
But bits and pieces of Komodo technology have been in development since 2014, actually. Mm-hmm. And it's so much more than privacy. We started building like multi-chain architectures back in 2014. We started working on atomic swaps back in the days, really. We were one of the first. So we reached a point over the years mm-hmm. where privacy is really just a tiny part of what Komodo is doing.
Yeah.
It's not just a privacy coin, and it's not really what we focus on at the moment.
So you've been around for a long time. So you're saying that you've been pivoting your product as to where the market needs you to be? Or have you been just internally learning and you decided to take a different strategy?
It was more of an internal learning.
Okay.
Like, we were working on different bits and pieces of technology.
Yeah.
And, you know, it just all came together at a point, and we realized we have something much bigger than just a privacy solution.
I see. Okay. And why is it that you are doing what you're doing right now? What problem is Komodo really solving today?
So the shortest pitch I could give you, and this will sound a mouthful, so let me explain a little bit later. So what we're building is a interoperable multi-chain ecosystem or a platform that other projects or companies can build applications on.
Yep.
And that's very confusing. No one ever understood this pitch because it is complicated. So let me give you an example. Let me start with our vision. I think Komodo has a very strong vision. We believe in a world where you have hundreds or thousands or hundreds of thousands of blockchains working in unison, performing very complex business tasks.
Right.
Let me give you an example. Imagine three blockchains. There's one blockchain with your health data, something like a medical blockchain. Maybe it's a government blockchain. You have another blockchain for your insurance company with your premium. Different use case.
Yep.
And maybe you have a third one. You're a sporty guy. There's one with your activity tracker.
I like that.
I know you like that. That tracks your movements, tracks your exercise, and so on. So if these three chains can work together, mm-hmm. if your Fitbit can inform your insurance company about how healthy you are, your heart rate, and if your insurance company can work with the data from your medical records, suddenly you have something very complex. But you need a platform where these chains can truly work together.
Yep.
Because if they live in silos, you're missing out on half of the fun and 90% of the use cases.
Right, right. Then I'm going to challenge you a little bit because from my knowledge, the crowd is quite, the space is quite crowded. Well, like Ethereum is trying to build this.
Yep.
So how are you differentiating from Ethereum and the other interoperability platforms out there, right?
Yeah, no, that's an excellent question. And yeah, the platform space is indeed crowded.
Yep.
I think we have three big differentiators.
Mm-hmm.
So one is Ethereum, Tezos, and all these big platforms. Like, you have one chain. You are sharing the same chain with different projects. And that can be good, but that comes with a lot of limitations.
Right.
Scalability, speed, computational power, and so on. So we give projects their own blockchains.
Mm-hmm.
Every project building on Komodo has their own blockchain. We call them smart chains, by the way, and we will talk about it why. So if you build on Ethereum, you don't control the underlying layer.
Right.
And that's a problem. So blockchain sovereignty, it's not something that you hear often, but I think this concept of blockchain sovereignty is going to be a big deal in the coming years.
Right.
The second one is smart contracts. So Ethereum obviously pioneered smart contracts, and they're pretty good. The problem is they are not very smart. And there are a number of reasons for that, but the main one is the gas model.
Right.
It's very difficult to build complex business applications on Ethereum because you will hit that gas problem very quickly.
Yeah.
So we also have a smart contract solution. We call them Antara modules. And these modules run directly on the nodes themselves.
Right, right.
So you don't hit like a performance limit and you don't need to pay gas.
Right.
And the third one, which I think is equally as important, Ethereum is a single chain architecture. If you want to do interoperability with maybe something like Bitcoin or a proof of work chain, you have to go through like a central player, probably an exchange. So we have the atomic swap technology. You can swap your Fitbit coins to Bitcoin natively without going through any centralized entity.
And Polkadot, Icon, Aeon, they're working on that solution as well.
They
right?
are working on a very similar solution. So I think all of these technologies are very interesting.
Yep.
I think there is one crucial part where we believe ours is better. And Polkadot is a good example. So Polkadot is fantastic technology. It truly is. But I believe the business model is not that great. Like, you have to rent a chain.
Right.
Like, think about it.
Right.
Like, are we really going to trade one gatekeeper for another gatekeeper?
Mm-hmm.
So if you build on Komodo, you don't need permission. You don't need to pay rent for a chain.
Right.
You don't even need to connect. You don't need permission. You can start developing. We don't even know about it.
Right.
And we believe that's right.
Clear. Well, you make your point. What we always do within iBlock TV is also ask, what is your tip for the crypto investor right now at this current day and age here at the Asia Blockchain Summit in Taipei?
Buy Bitcoin, obviously. But I think buy platform coins as well.
Right.
If our vision is right, then there is going to be space for 2, 3, maybe 4 big platforms in this space over the next few years. And I hope Komodo will be one of them.
Yep.
But yeah, that sounds like a good investment. Also, this is decidedly not investment advice.
Right. No, clear. And what about entrepreneurs right now? I'm asking that question to everybody today. If you would start a crypto or blockchain business today, which is vastly different from 2017, what would you recommend these entrepreneurs over here?
Find your niche. Find your vertical. I think it maybe doesn't make that much sense to build the 20th medium of exchange coin. Find something that has a true real world use case, and you will not have any problems with finding funding. Because blockchain has plenty of use cases. Blockchain is not a silver bullet. It's not good for anything. But there are a few things where it's just perfect. And I think there's a lot of room to grow there.
Thank you so much, Thorsten, and have a great day here at the Asia Blockchain.
You're most welcome.
All right.
Thank you, man.
So much.
Take care.